video, we have discussed about few trigger context variable like trigger dot is insert, is update, is delete. This video, we're going to talk about few more trigger context variable, which is new map, old and old map. This is something that we use a lot because this is the variable which will help you to bring the data inside your trigger. All you are doing is just the data manipulation. Your Apex class is doing what? Just checking that what data that has been entered by the user, and you are doing some backend calculation and doing at the end the insert, update, delete, the backend operations. Correct? So trigger.new, trigger.new map, trigger.old, trigger.old map, these variable will bring the data in the table. Let me just explain this with an example. Okay, understand this trigger.new. This variable trigger.new, right? What it does, it returns a list of new version of the S-object records. This S-object list is only available in insert, update, and delete. Okay. So let's say you have an opportunity record, same opportunity record that I have created, right? What you're doing is the record that you had created, that record amount was null. It was blank. But then you edited and put it 100 and saved. So what is the new value? 100. What was the old value? Null. Are you getting me? Let's say this is the opportunity that has been created and you are updating it. You are changing the stage. You are changing the stage from prospecting to closed own. So what was the old value? Prospecting. What is the new value? Closed own. Now if you have to get the old value in your Apex trigger to do some calculation, then how do you get it? This variable will help you to get it. New. Trigger.new will help you to get the new value. This record has many fields. Every single field has new value and old value whenever you are updating. Suppose you are editing this record and you are changing nothing. You are changing nothing. In this case, what was your old value of amount and what is your new value of amount? 100 and 100. You change nothing. Your old value and new value is same. What if I have to check? Suppose whenever you update an opportunity, you have to check if the stage has not been changed. Then you do something. How do you compare it? How do you know what was the old value and what is the new value? And based on that, how can you take a decision? Is what you have to use trigger.new and trigger.old. This variable, new variable, it will return a list of new version of the records. This variable will return a list of old version of the record. Got it? So whatever the old values, each and every field has some value. It could be either null or it could be filled with some value, but it would be, there should be some value. And if you want to get the old values and new values, you have to use the trigger.new. Now let's go ahead and try to implement this two variable. I'm going to open the same Apex trigger. What is the object? Opportunity trigger. That's the trigger we have written, right? Double click. And this is the trigger. Here, I'm going to print system.debug.trigger.new. Okay. And I'm going to copy this. Plus. Okay. Now, this is a question to you. Understand this and tell me. Okay. What do you think? Trigger.new variable will be loaded with data when? So to fill this, right, let's just do this dry run. Suppose you're inserting a brand new record. Please understand this line, okay? You're inserting a brand new record. Do you think the trigger.old will have some value? No, right? You're inserting a brand new record. What was the old value? There was no old value. Whenever you're inserting, it should be only new value. Correct? What about if you are updating? If you are updating, that means there was some old value, there is some new value. So trigger.old, trigger.new will work. What about delete? if let's say you are deleting this record, do you think tigger.new will have some value? No, right? Tigger.old, yes, it will have some value. The old record you are deleting. What I'm trying to say is this. See, understand this line. New variable. This S object list is only available on insert, update, and undelete. Like insert, update, and delete. Undelete is also another operations. What do you mean by undelete? You know, right? Whenever you delete something, it should go to the recycle bin. And from the recycle bin, if you restore the data, that is nothing but undelete. And whenever you do this undelete, if you want to fire your trigger, you have to use this undelete in your event. This line is very important. You have to understand this line. This says that trigger.new will be loaded with value whenever insert happen, update happen, and undelete happen. Whenever you are inserting, the new value will be there because you are inserting new value. Whenever you are updating, you have new and old both the values. And whenever you are undeleting, undeleting means you are getting the data back from the recycle bin to the, let's say, opportunity object. So the record is being inserting again. So in this case, new value will be there. I hope theoretically it is clear. When you do the practical, this would be crystal clear. Okay, let us go and print the trigger.new. Okay, I'm gonna go here to my Apex code. Now, as you have understand the theoretical part, you tell me here, do you think trigger.new, I'm just gonna copy this line, Control X, do you think trigger.new will be there in the case of before insert? Let's do one thing. Let's just print both this trigger.new, trigger.old in every single events. Okay, so I am actually printing trigger.new old in before insert, after insert, before update, after update, every single event. I want to ask you this question. What if I go and insert a brand new record here? I'm just going to go and clone the same old record. If I click on save, what will be the value in the trigger.new and what will be the value in the trigger.old? That's a question to you. I have inserted a brand new record and what will be the value in my trigger.new, because this will fire, right? Before insert, after insert, both this will fire. In the case of before insert, what will be the value of new and old? In the case of after insert, what will be the value of new and old? Can you please guess? Let me quickly open the log and double click. Debug only. Check this out. See, in the case of before insert, yeah, trigger.new has some value. Any reason why both is coming as trigger.new, trigger.new is because I've done a small mistake here. See, both these cases I have written trigger.new only. Are you getting me here? I have written trigger.new in both cases. So this is, you understand this line, right? The trigger.new is loaded with the data in the case of before insert. Trigger.old doesn't have any data, but that makes sense, right? I mean, if you're inserting a record, how come you get the old value? There's no old value. It is all new value only. So your trigger.new will be loaded with the data, but not the old one. In the case of after insert, same thing. Your trigger.new has the data, but not the old. Correct? Don't get confused with this trigger.new and trigger.new, because I have written both here trigger.new and trigger.new only. These all are conceptual questions I'm trying to ask you. This will help you to think about it, right? Why I'm getting ID is null in the case of before insert and in the case of after insert, the ID is there. What is the reason? In the case of before insert, trigger.new, there is no ID. ID is null. You know what is ID, right? ID is basically, this is the ID. 005. You see here in this URL, that's the ID. So that ID was null in the case of before insert, trigger.new, but that ID is loaded in the case of after insert. Why? If you understand the previous concept, this would be clear to you, but let me just explain this. See, when you insert a record, Salesforce will generate this ID whenever the record has been inserted. In the case of before insert, the record has not been inserted yet. It is yet to be inserted. In the case of after insert, yes, the record has been inserted. That's why in the case of after insert, Salesforce is giving you this ID. In the case of before insert, there is no ID. Are you getting me? How come this ID gets created? Because once the record hits the database, it creates the record ID. So in the case of before insert, the record has not been created yet. How do you get the ID? You'll not get the ID, right? And in the case of after insert, record has already been created. So Salesforce has given you the ID. That's the reason why in the case of before insert, the ID is null. In the case of after insert, the ID is loaded with ID. Okay. So trigger.new, trigger.old in the case of insert is clear. Now let's do the same operation in the case of update. Okay. Before I do, I want to ask you these questions. What do you think what's going to happen if I go and edit this record and click on save? Definitely before update and after update, both these will fire. In the case of before update, what will be the value in trigger.new and trigger.old? Do you think the trigger.old will be blank? No, right? See, in the case of update, you have old and new, both the values. You're updating. You didn't change anything in this record. So the old value of amount is 100 and the new value is also 100, correct? So let's go here and check this out. Double click. Debug only. See this. This will fire on before update. See, before update, the opportunity ID and all the values are same. This is the trigger.old value. In the case of after update, new and old value. Both are same because I did not change anything. Now, I'm going to go and change something. Let's say I'm going to go and change the amount. Okay, where is the amount? See, amount is 100. Before update, the amount was 100. And the old value is also 100. Why? Because I didn't change anything. Now, I'm going to go and change the amount. I will edit this. Change the amount from 100 to 200. What do you think what's going to happen? Any guess? Double click. Debug only. Here we go. See this. In the case of before update, the new value is 200. The old value is 100. In the case of after update, the new value is 200. Old value is 100. Both the case of before and after, the new and old value will be same only. Right? The new value and old value will be same. Its new value is 200, old value is 100. In the case of before update and after update. Right? See, these variables called trigger.new, trigger.old will just facilitate you the data inside your trigger. Now, if I have to check, hey, check something in the trigger, which will be like this. Okay. If the new value of the amount is more than 150, do something. How do you do it? You have to get this new value from the trigger.new, extract the value and then check. This is exactly what we're going to learn in the next video. So trigger.new, trigger.old is pretty much clear. Next video, we're going to see the trigger.new map and trigger.old map. Okay. And we'll also see how to extract the data. Now your variable is loaded with the data. How do you get the data out of this variable? This is something small mechanism that you have to learn. All right. So see you in the next video.